Before I speak, is there a tribal girl student here? Any tribal girl student? Please come here. I just landed here and I discovered that I also did not know that this book has come out. One of your students here, even before the author got the copy, he bought it online. This is my autobiography. This girl will read it. Experiments with untruth. And what's untruth? You buy the book, tomorrow it sells on online, he bought it. Stand up. First he bought this guy. both of you bought it, is it? Right, okay. Okay, hold this and give to them. At the outset, let me thank the Department of Political Science, Delhi University, for unanimously rejecting the standing committee proposal and keeping my books in the syllabus as of now. Now friends, when we are discussing about how to write books, what method we need to use, and what is the truth that we need to tell, this has huge implications for Indian universities all over. The question today is, BJP and RSS intellectuals always want to compete with Pakistan intellectuals. That is their central this thing. But I want all of you and my nation to compete with entire Europe, American, Chinese intellectuals. Because this nation is ours. It is the Adivasi, the girl, her parents, grandparents, grandparents, and the Dalit, their grandparents, grandparents, the whole Shudras. This category Shudra from Jat in this area, Gujar, Patel, Maratha, to Kamma Reddy, to the Dhobis, or historically the Shudra category. It is they who made this nation, not the Brahmin Banyans. They did not make this. Now they took over the resources of the nation and they wrote some books in that process. Now, what method I use? Praveen asked me, you must tell, are you an organic intellectual when you are writing, or are you an anorganic intellectual? Or are you, see, when I started writing way back in 1977, my first article, immediately after my MPhil admission, got published in mainstream. I started writing as a shepherd.
a shepherd who keeps on going around sheep, I used to keep on reading. So there is a shepherd method. Now, every producer, every builder of economy has a methodology. When the Harappa city was built by a man's team whose name was Harappa, in down south, my shepherd community's god's name was Birappa. So my god was Harappa's great-great-grandson, who was driven to South India, and he built the sheep economy there. And entire Karnataka is Appa's. So their brick was made, their pot was made, their wood crafted, urban cities were built. When cities were built without villages, there could not have been cities. And in entire Rig Veda, entire Yajur Veda, Sama Veda, Adharva Veda, you read all these texts, there is no knowledge of brick making. Now, is brick making a scientific process or not? Does it have a methodology or not? Can you ask any sannyasi? There are historically Brahmin sannyasis, all sitting under tree. But there is also a Shudra sannyasi called Ramdev. We'll ask him to make a brick that just like that. Can he make? A brick maker has a methodology. So, historically in the world, when human knowledge began to build around production, engagement with nature, those people who, after the literacy got formed, began to search for knowledge from different people. Not only is our own experience, but from different people, and write into some kind of a text. This is called search for knowledge. This is the first form of constructing the text. Later on, after Renaissance only, when the universities got advanced, there was a new kind of methodology that came in.
Friends, before I speak, is there a tribal girl student here? Any tribal girl student? Please come here. I just landed here and I discovered that I also did not know that this book has come out. One of your students here, even before the author got the copy, he bought it online. This is my autobiography. This girl will read it.
Experiments with untruth. Untruth, you buy the book, tomorrow itself on online, e-bought it. Stand up.
firstly bought this guy. Both of them, you both of you bought it, is it? Right, okay. Okay, all they sent him to that. At the outset, let me thank the Department of Political Science, Delhi University, for unanimously rejecting the standing committee proposal and keeping my books in the syllabus as of now. Now friends, when we are discussing about how to write books, what method we need to use, and what is the truth that we need to tell, this has huge implications for Indian universities all over. The question today is, BJP and RSS intellectuals always want to compete with Pakistan intellectuals. That is their central, this thing. But I want all of you and my nation to compete with entire Europe, America and Chinese intellectuals. Because this nation is ours. It is the Adivasi, the girl, her parents, grandparents, grandparents, and the Dalit, their grandparents, grandparents, the whole Shudras. This category Shudra from Jat in this area, Gujar, Patel, Maratha, to Kamma, Reddy, to the Dhobis, or historically the Shudra category. It is they who made this nation, not the Brahmin Banyans. They did not make this. Now they took over the resources of the nation and they wrote some books in that process. Now, what method I use, you know, Praveen asked me, you must tell, are you an organic intellectual when you are writing? Or are you an inorganic intellectual? Or are you... See, when I started writing way back in 1977, my first article, immediately after my MPhil admission, got published in mainstream, I started writing as a shepherd. A shepherd who keeps on going around sheep. I used to keep on reading. So there is a shepherd method. Now, every producer, every builder of economy has a methodology. When the Harappa city was built by a man's team whose name was Harappa. In down south, my shepherd community's god's name was Birappa. So my god was Harappa's great-great-grandson, who was driven to South India. And he built a sheep economy there. And entire Karnataka is Appa's. So their brick was made. Their pot was made, their wood crafted, urban cities were built. When cities were built without villages, there could not have been cities. And in entire Rigveda, entire Ayurveda, Samaveda, Adharvaveda, you read all these texts. There is no knowledge of brick making.
Now, is brickmaking a scientific process or not? Does it have a methodology or not? Can you ask any sannyasi? There are historically Brahmin sannyasis, all sitting under tree. But there is also a Shudra sannyasi called Ramdev. We'll ask him to make a brick that just like that. Can he make? A brick maker has a methodology. So historically in the world, when human knowledge began to build around production, engagement with nature, those people who after the literacy got formed began to search for knowledge from different people, not only is our own experience, but from different people, and write into some kind of a text. This is called search for knowledge. This is the first form of constructing the text. Later on, after Renaissance only, when the universities got advanced, there was a new kind of methodology that came in. From this Ramayana, Mahabharata, all that is a facade. Who wrote, whether the writer is true or not, Vedas, no name. The first real writer was Kautilya. He wrote Ardhashastra. Are there footnotes to Ardhashastra? Are there quotations in that? Are there citations? So why are you teaching him? So, when I started doing research, I started in the normal course of university. That is where my PhD on Gautam Buddha's political philosophy was heavily cited, heavily referenced. I went round several libraries, including the Calcutta National Library, because I wanted to capture the original arguments of Gautam Buddha as against the contemporary Brahmin pundits of his time. And then I derived a methodological argument that the notion of republican democracy was constructed in India by Gautam Buddha much before it existed in Greek and in China. So then I said that this thought, Buddha's thought, is compared with Plato, Aristotle, Confucius, and finally I said the earliest human thinker on political issues, social issues, man-woman equality is Gautam Buddha in the world. And this book they wrote about. God as a political philosopher. Now, I can understand other books because they read titles and they are afraid. Reviewer publisher asked me, how could you get these titles? I said, no, I don't know. See, I am a shepherd, Ilaiah. There is my goddess Pochamma. She gives me titles. She is under the tree only. And my goddess Pochamma in the village Telangana knows very good English, better English than me. Their thoughts don't understand because they understand only Sanskrit. So, my titles, post Hindu India, I is saying that Hinduism will die. Only then post Hindu. Actually, when I thought of post Hindu India title, when postmodernism debate was happening, in many seminars I attended, I said, this is not being understood by us. What is this postmodernism? So the only way we can really work out our method is we should talk about post Hindu system. Ambedkar's expansion of that. Why I am not a Hindu? Then they are saying, is he saying why I am not a Hindu? Now he has this name, Shepherd. He is already a Christian. I said, how to know? We should ask Jesus. But even though you study in Oxford, Cambridge, Harvard, you don't know Jesus' English. I only know that. You can't understand Jesus' English. Jesus is only God who understands our languages. See, the problem for them is, no Brahmin thinker, whatever the school, has an experience of production knowledge in their lifetime. And when they don't have production knowledge, naturally their engagement with nature is limited. And the relationship with nature and production alone gives the philosophical understanding. Now, most of the philosophies at a higher plane were formed by religion through Dharma. Now, it is here in Mandal period, they were abusing backward classes. They were saying these stupid fellows want to come into universities. And they want reservations in 1919. And everybody, even the right-wing intellectuals, leave alone. There are no intellectuals. In fact, yesterday when Rahul Gandhi wrote to me, he put once a point very straight. BJP, RSS groups don't have intellectuals. They don't want to allow other intellectuals to live in this earth at all. This is a very serious observation. Though he's a very young man. See, the problem is, there were no intellect, but there were left Brahmins, liberal Brahmins, and secular Brahmins. They were all opposed to reservation. And I wanted to write an article to convince them that why we need reservation. Then I made an experiment, writing an essay which was published accidentally, EPW, Economic Political Theory. The title of the essay was Reservations, Experience as Framework of Debate. Now, then Mandal happened, the Mandal system battle went on, then they demolished Pavlins. At that time, they were saying, we are all Hindus, Hindu majority. These Muslims have to be finished. Their masjids have to be finished. Now, who were they including as Hindus? All Shudras and Shudra. A Jat, a Maratha, a Gujar who till the land. Somebody looks after sheep, somebody is a carpenter, somebody is a shoemaker, somebody is... Each profession is different. But in original Rigvedic division, there were only four categories. The Shudras, who were slaves. I come from that heritage. Sardar Patel came from that heritage. And therefore he is Iron Man. See, Gandhi came from Banya heritage, therefore he is Mahatma. And Nehru came from Brahmin heritage, therefore he is Pandit. See, our Shudras, they don't understand, no philosophy. That's what I'm saying. They don't. Therefore, they are very happy with Iron Man. No big problem. If we are Iron Man, then that means we are hardware. We have no software. So, what these right-wing people understood is, there is a great living software among Shudras. That is this Kancha Ilaiah. So what to do with it? Because I am not an Iron Man. Look at me, how far I am, how to study. So the question is, I looked at a methodology after that essay. Let me go to villages and study whether any life process of a Shudra, because I am not a Hindu, subtitle is a Shudra critique of Hindutva, political economy, culture and philosophy. It is a Shudra critique. It is not a Dalit critique. It is not an untouchable critique. Post-Hindu India's subtitle is Dalit Bahujan, See, why this hyphen actually later they created in Hindi. I am not a Hindu. It's only Dalit Bahujan, one word. It is the media which created. Dalit Bahujan, a socio-scientific intellectual, a discourse in socio-scientific philosophical revolution. Buffalo nationalism subtitle is a critical spiritual fascism. Buffalo nationalism. They are saying cow nation, cow nation, cow nation. Cow is white, therefore it's nation. And North India is cow belt. Cow belt. Then I thought, by being in Hyderabad in South, I should call South as Buffalo belt. See, this whole logic works. If you are calling this cow belt, though there are a number of black people here, all Shudras are black. So you are calling it Buffalo cow belt, I should call my. So I, as against cow nationalism business was going on everywhere, though cow does not give much milk. They drink buffalo milk and then they abuse buffalo because it's black. And the irrationality is so much, black color on buffalo body is common, bad, but if your hair become white, you paint black on the head. That is Hindu. Very black hair on the head, Hinduism. White no on the head, it doesn't work. See, this is the problem. Then what I did was, I went into the villages, studied the entire Shudra, Dalit, Adivasi life. From childhood to death, what is the difference between a Brahmin life, a Baniya life, and the Shudra, Dalit, Adivasi life? In production, in childhood, what in would be, how we play, to death, how we differ in death. See, finally, in I am not a Hindu, there are two formulations. You must see that. A nation which can survive and grow and challenge the imperial nations is possible only with a process of labor as life. Labor as life versus leisure as life. Now this Gita Bhatt was saying Kancha Ilaiah is opposing sannyasi in the book. How can we teach it? I said, sannyasis live only as total leisure as life and eat most of the food in the country. How does the nation grow? You know what? Whereas samsari produces food for children. So the battle is between samsari and sannyasi. Sannyasis are ruling now. See, any democracy that is ruled by, I am telling my RSS friends on the BJP, any democracy, any nation that is ruled by sannyasis will not prosper. For the simple reason, they can't understand family. They can't understand child. They can't understand economy. They can't understand. They want to have a seat in the swarga. So we should allow them to go soon. Seat there, no? So instead of that, if you rule state is gone. Whether it is Catholicism, whether it is Protestant religion, whether it is the Muslim world, anywhere, religious mullahs, bishops ruling, the state will not prosper. It is the politician who is a family member has to rule. Because he understands, family is an economic unit. Therefore, I said, labor as life and leisure as life. That they don't understand. Oh, he is saying that all leisure people are waste, therefore, we are all waste. Yes, you are all waste. Now, I am not saying you will be killed, no. You will have to be sent to till the land, make the pot, sweep the road. And those people have to come into universities, then you can develop this within 20 years. Because knowledge production is a process of work. Production. Knowledge production and food production are not two different processes. They are one and the same. In post-Hinduism, What is the experiment I did? It is a book of 10 years of research among tribals, Dalits, all Shudra castes, and also on Banyas and Brahmin community. I drew a line between all Shudras and Dalits Adivasis as one block, as people of production. And the two castes, Brahmins and Banyas, as people of anti-production. Not even non-product, they are anti-production. Because in your all philosophical books, production is shown as pollution. Immense universe. In all his books, says all meat food is pollution. Shudra food is pollution. Dalit food is pollution. Only birakaya, bendakaya, dal is pure. Then can you fight Chinese and China border by eating dal, bendi, this and that? Can you fight China with yoga? Who is defined as Hindu? If you define as Hindu and you don't have the right to directly approach the God, talk to him or her, and read the text repeatedly, because it was a priest who also philosophized the world. Shudras won't have that. Patel did not have that. Why Patel did not write? Because Patel thought, I am a Shudra, I should not write. Gandhi wrote his autobiography. Nehru wrote his autobiography. When Nehru was writing in the same jail, Patel was helping them in all of the things. He did not write anything. As a result, the whole Shudra community lost the knowledge. Coming from him would have been great strength to us. Now, it is true that the only source of knowledge from Shudras is Mahatma Phule, Savitribai Phule, the first Shudra to write. Then a little bit through lectures, speeches from Periyar and Narayan Guru in some other way. But that is not a high-level systematic argument textual process. Why I am not a Hindu was prescribed by Columbia University in 2012. The same RSS people there opposed. And there were, the professor who introduced it said, who are you to oppose? What we should do? Why are you coming and telling us? Then he said, why are you telling, teaching this? Why are you not teaching Waraks? Why I am not a Muslim? A better research, why I am not a Christian? He said in two sentences. Did you read all of them? Without reading, you are talking. Those two books don't talk about detailed cultures. Why I am not a Hindu? Full of Indian culture. So any introductory reading, people understand what is India in this book. And better lessons to Why I am not a Christian is not a book, it's one essay, small essay. They don't read. So I request those who are working with ABVP, RSS, please read books. No, you are my Indian. You are my Indian. There are a number of Shudras. There are a number of OBCs. And you don't have the right to God as I don't have. No, I wanted to actually become a priest in Tirupati temple. But they said, you can't become. They asked me a question that, do you know Sanskrit to become a priest? I said, does Tirupati Ankana as a god knows only one language? Let me become. I will teach him English, he will teach me Sanskrit. Supreme Court also allowed that. Now, Patel can't. Poor this Venkaya Naidu does not. He is suffering inside. He can't become the priest in Tirupati temple. His son cannot become. If he Mohan Bhagavat will not allow that. No Shudra has become the head of RSS in now. Why? Why? OBC Shudras are there only as Iron Man to beat Muslims. Beat Christians? You are only that only? Then why don't you directly talk to God? that God will tell you what is real. But they are not allowing. Therefore, the point today is, we have to write first-hand knowledge, because for 3,000-4,000 years, entire Shudra community's knowledge, Dalit community's knowledge, and tribal community's knowledge is not textualized. When first time you textualize, you have no quotation possible. This problem came to be, you all know about subaltern studies, right? Yeah, in one of 9th volumes, my essay from Why I'm Not a Hindu, an extracted essay was published. And that is the only essay which is not footnoted in the entire book. They said they objected. They wanted me to quote. They called me from Australia. I said, whom should I quote? You have not written anything on that. But knowledge is, see, writing one book by reading 10 books, 20 books is nothing but lift irrigation research. It is lift irrigation. Whereas writing from directly people's knowledge, people's history, history is not in books in India today. History is living in the villages. We have to record it. Every shepherd has a history of his own from today's to Harappa linking. And every pot maker has a history from today's pot to Harappa time pot making. And your entire Vedic period here had no economy. That is the reason why the Vedic period is known as pastoral economy. Pastoral economy means there were no villages. There were no cities. Till Buddhism came, there were no cities after they destroyed Indus Valley cities. The first city later built was Pataliputra. And the same people who are leading from Bihar as intellectuals, you go and see how clean Patna is. I was crying. Dirty people. People bathe on the roads, eat on the roads. Hyderabad, which was ruled by a Muslim Nizam, is the neatest city in the country today. Why did you do this? What credit you are? So friends, my point is, okay, they might remove my books. But what we have to prove is, reading does not mean only classroom reading. Reading does not mean only classroom. Writing does not mean only examination writing. Now what you have to write is, get back to your village, write your family histories, all of them. And let the family histories come into universities. Once all Shudra come in, all Dalits, all backward classes, all tribals write their history, all Indian universities full of our books, nobody can change them. Nobody can change them. Therefore, today they are dead scared. I'll tell you what their strategy is. Their strategy is, since they got for the first time, telling Narendra Modi, as I proved in my Karwan article, he actually does not come from a Shudra family. He comes from Modganchi Vaishya family, which was doing oil business, but they took OBC citizenship. There are number of Baniyas in North India who took OBC citizenship. They became OBCs, but they are actually anti-reservationists. I face them many times on the TV channels. But the Shudras, the Patel, George Gujars, how many Patel professors are there in your daily? How many Gujar professors are there? How many George professors are there? Can you show me? 4, 5? No. All this land is theirs. They did not become professors. The only problem was, Brahmins owned Sanskrit at that time, and Saraswati was goddess of Sanskrit at that time. After the British left, they shifted the whole thing into English. Goddess Saraswati also shifted into English. 4 classes, castes learned English. Brahmins, Baniyas, all industrial baniyas learn English. Their mother tongue is English. Kayasthas and Khatris. Manmohan Singh comes from that background. Khatris. These people are in institutions in Delhi. No students. So my effort is, I must work till my death to bring all Shudras into universities as professors. And how do you do it? The only way to do it is, let us make a beginning a fight that all government schools must be made English medium. All government schools. So at one time, you control Sanskrit. Even in the Mughal period, Muslim period, you controlled Persian language. And for Shudras, there is no All India language. We live in villages, in regions. Shudra rulers also are now finished during BJP time. No Shudra ruler in any state. So therefore, now the struggle is, why this happened, I tell you. This is Goldwalker's. The main thesis book, we are our nation to be formed. In this, he worked out a theory for nation, quoting only from Western scholars, writers, without giving any footnote from which book, where only some names are there, quotations are there, which, what is the book, there is nothing anywhere, but in the 54 and 55 page, he made the fundamental thesis which RSS BJP are implementing. What is the thesis? That when state comes into our hand, we must implement Varna Dharma. That means classical fourfold Varna system should be brought back. The Britishers have disturbed it. Later on, the Nehruvian democracy has disturbed it. Some Shudras have come here. Some Dalits are now ruling. Some Dalits are professors. And unfortunately, like him, with a strong body, strong mind. So, I'll just read up. See, we have to expose this. This is completely anti-national. Today, if you want the old caste system to get back, the Vedic caste system, then where does the nation stand? What is China today? What is the kind of knowledge China is producing? You are talking about your industrial merit without reservation. You know, there is this Aruna Goswami. He keeps shouting all the time. One day he called me on the Times now. At that time he was on Times now. That day the MPs in the parliament, BC MPs, decided that there must be a reservation in private sector. So he called me, I was in Chennai. He started with me, Professor Kancha Ilaiah. This night it has to be settled. As if the nation has no, the whole nation, you have destroyed the country with reservations in government system. You! Now, you want to destroy the private sector also. What happens? This has to be decided today. I had very patiently. I said, Aruna, actually his name is Goswami, Netran is known as Kausami. Go is cow, no? Go is cow. One of the joker put it. So I said, Aruna, you don't have any merit. Why are you talking all this? You don't have any merit. What do you mean? I said, did your father, grandfather, or grandfather's grandfather, did they any time till the land? Without tilling land, where is the merit? Did you look after one buffalo, one cow, one bull? Any one animal you fed in your lifetime, in your generations? Did your women cut any crop? You people were eating all our food without any work. What are you talking about merit? Then he said, you are talking about my caste. I said, yes, I am talking about your caste. I am talking about your caste. See, the point is, all media is, there are my friends now. They publish me also. The entire media in Delhi consists of only four castes. Brahmins, Baniyas, Payastas and Patnis. You see Chatterjee from Mukherjee, Patnis from Bengal. Bengal is huge Shudra population. We don't even know the caste names. And the whole of Haryana, Punjab, no job. I ask in each TV channel, is there a single Jat girl anywhere? Is there a single Patel girl anywhere in any or boy? And no, because they are happy with Hindi. These people were learning English. They were going to Oxford, Harvard, and coming back and here abusing colonialism, imperialism, globalization. We thought to be great thinkers. This is nothing but lift irrigation from those books. So we have to do solid indigenous Indian nationalist work. What is he saying? The place where people characterized by varnas and ashrams is talking about the nation that is visualizing to build in future. This book was written in 1939. The place where a people characterized by varnas and ashrams enrich itself, characterized by varnas and ashrams, that is following the Hindu framework of society. Obeying the Hindu codes, in short, subscribing to the Hindu religion and culture, that is important. The people in the country must be Hindus by religion and culture, and consequently by language. What language? At that time, Sanskrit, now English for them in private schools. Not in government schools. Rakesh Sinha, he was spokesperson for RSS for 5 months, then becomes Rajya Sabha member. Has he written any book? Any publisher published? The people who oppose my books, you go and see in Google there, one is Geeta Bhatt, I believe, the other one is Kaviraj Suman. Google their bio. Did they write any book? Is there any review for any book? Which publisher published? My book, my autobiography is published by Sage. Post Hindu India is published by Sage. My Nehru Fellowship book is published by Pearson. Young man, what are you thinking? You don't write anything? Judge on books who are written by others. You can't say academics. Now, one of the tragedies of the right wing is they don't do search and research. They don't want search and research in this country. Now, okay, I read, is there anybody who read all Vedas, Ramayana, Mahabharata, Bhagavad Gita, more rigorously than Ambedkar? You see how seriously he read? I asked generations of generation students coming from upper class, Brahmins and Baniyas, in women's college, men's college, how many of you read Bhagavad Gita? Not even one. I asked how many of you saw Bhagavad Gita? And these two professors who opposed my book, leave alone reading, they did not see the books also. See, God has political philosophy is my PhD thesis with full of quotations. They should have seen it before saying that there is no references, this and that. They did not see. Now, therefore, see, whatever right school, left school, whatever you did, earlier leftist intellectual, anything you need to quote Marx, Lenin, Mao, Stalin, for anything. That is also completely wrong. The tragedy of the left school is it has not produced an outstanding thinker like Ambedkar from its camp. Who do do I project like Ambedkar? Do I do it? Sundaraya, I respect, but he has written only one book, that is on struggle. E.M.S. Nambudripa, that's not very talented writing. Jyoti Basu has not written anything. What do I do? So the problem is, you don't do, and but for one Ambedkar, this country would have been completely destroyed. Indian democracy would not have suffered. Even Nehru Gandhi would not accept it. So today, our role is, they might do anything. The Shudras, Dalits, Adivasis, and the Brahmin Banyas, and the Pashtas, everybody, please study production and the production relations and the nature of this country, going into the forest and going into the villages. Now, tomorrow onwards, we must have a demand. Nationalism, yes, we should have nationalism. From tomorrow onwards, nobody who gets a degree from Oxford, Harvard, Cambridge should be given a job in India at all. Let us see who will not get those jobs. SCST OBCs, coming to JNU is going much difficult than going to Oxford for us. Right? They go there and come back. You get PhD here, you do everything. Then they sit in the selection committee and say, not eligible. As if you are eligible. For 4,000 years, you have written a book which is not eligible anywhere in any world. Seen and eligibility sum it has is the Kama Sutras. Any market it is available in the West. No other book. Which thinker book is read? You know, today my books are read in the West more than any other Indian writers. Perhaps you know Romila Thapar and few of others are also read. But my books are read from village to America, Parliament. When there is an attack on me, why did American Parliament pass a resolution? Kancha Ilaiah is according to there is an attack, it is an attack on intellectual, global intellectual knowledge. Why? I didn't get a degree from the Chidambaram, these people, all these people. They went and there's one, I believe, Raju Malhotra came here from there. He doesn't know anything about India. Safely lives in America without any problems there and comes and teaches something about non-translatability of Sanskrit, I believe. Is that a great language there? If language is not translatable, it is not a language. If it is not translatable, it is not language. He is thinking that he is telling a great theory. It is absolute rubbish. See, the question is, you study in Oxford, Cambridge, Harvard, and you are dead inferior against the white intellectual there. You try to come here, you know, pretend to be superior against this SCST OBCs here. Because we were only physical people telling, you tell and we go and beat others. With my books coming, our people will not be, they will only do intellectual writing. No beating anybody. More, after any man reads my books, if he gets married, he cannot beat his wife. I can't say if wife beats that. That's that. There is that strength in, see, you see the continuous women angle in my books. And there is one chapter in Posting to India called Subaltern Feminist. You know about whom it is? It is about Dhobis. How Dhobi women discovered soil soaps much before the world had discovered soap. How Dhobi people washed clothes by boiling them at Dhobi Ghat. To study Dhobi Ghat, it took me 3 months, their knowledge. And they never had a kitchen of their own. Then I said, the earliest socialist living without a family kitchen was in the Dhobi community. So was not in Lenin Russia. It was in Dobi community. No family. They took food from all families. Based on that, today we are now propagating in Telangana in this election. There must be people's food canteens in every village. 3 rupees breakfast, 5 rupees full lunch. Government canteen. Therefore, friends, see, knowledge production has now come to us. And they are dead scared of it. It is true now. The Delhi University experience is that knowledge is a fear. What knowledge production? Equality. What is our goal? My God is equality. One may come to one line, liberal may try to come, communist may try to come. We Americanite Marxists, we are trying to come through, go through that equality. BJP, RSS don't like equality at all. They are anti-equality. Therefore, the fear of equality theory is a fear of their history. But after Ambedkar was born in this country, that history is already buried. That history is already buried. What Kancha Ilaiah Shepherd is doing is only one more step further. Now they have end names, Chatterjee, Banerjee, Mukherjee, Trivedi, Chaturvedi, Dwivedi, Singh, all that. And when I add my name, Shepherd, they are saying, this is Christian. I said, no, it is not Christian, it is my parents' work. Now what I did by putting my name in English is, you fellows have become local, I have become international. So, Shudras must put the names like Tilak, Potter, Shoemaker, Soldier, all Mahars are soldiers. Was Gandhi's father a soldier in fact? Nehru's father a soldier? The only one man's father was soldier, that was on that who protected this place. I don't think Mohan Bamba's father had any idea of soldier. You ask him, interview him, go and interview. Was your father soldier? Your grandfather soldier? Was this? He was only doing Samarpayami Swaha. This Samarpayami, that Samarpayami, rice, money, earth, Swaha. This is not protection of nation. You didn't protect nation. All Dalits are soldiers in this country. If Dalits, OBC, Shudras are not there, China will walk into India within 5 days. It is not RSS protection. How can RSS protect? It is an organization of vegetarianism. Can you fight Pakistanis? Go and fight. Let RSS go out to fight Pakistanis. They will show. Dalits, Adivasis, by eating the big curry, go there, they will fight Pakistanis within few seconds. Or Chinese with food. What are you doing? This country belongs to the producers, not for the consumers. The consumers whose parents have not produced anything have no right to say, our books should not be taught. Your books, we are not saying your books should not be taught. They can be read by anybody. If you allow them to read, nobody will come to you. That is your problem. If your books are read, they will not come to you at all. So, you are anti-reading. You are anti-reading. Your family is anti-reading. You are anti-reading. Therefore, this country suffered anti-intellectual heritage. The Dalits, OBCs and now Shudras, because of our great heritage from Ambedkar, full of library, full of books, full of writing, and in one generation, that you just compare this man's English with Ambedkar's English. Or compare his English, I studied under a tree with single teacher of Telugu medium, learned this English not in Christian school, but on my own. In autobiography I wrote a detail. I learned English
First I saw one small book that taught me English called Communist Manifesto. I read it, the specter of Europe is haunting the communism, the specter of communism is haunting Europe. Workers of the world unite. Then I saw it's talking about me. It is talking about my parents. None of your books spoke like that. Then I read Gandhi's Hindu Swaraj. Are there full of quotations in it? Nothing. Whatever Gandhi thought he wrote, this is philosophy now. Whatever he thought. See, I'll go with one last example. Gandhi's autobiography is titled My Experiments with Truth. And to debunk it, I put a chapter in my book, My Experiments with Untruth. Now what I did is simple. Two people wrote autobiographies. One is Gandhi. Never wrote, of course, but that is a different. Sarvepalli Ramakrishnan wrote. I quoted both of them. Gandhi in his autobiography says at 18th year, one of his Muslim friends, he was married by then, and by then one child was, the first son was born. He was very big. A Muslim friend gave him a suggestion, you must eat meat to become strong. So one day, Gandhi ate goat meat. And then next day he goes to his friend, I believe, he writes this and tells him, you bloody fellow, you told to eat this meat, the whole night goat was crying in my stomach. That he wrote. Then what did I write? I am a shepherd boy. By 18th year, I must have eaten 80 goats. Not a single goat cried in my mouth. Its meat has become part of my meat. Its blood has become part of my blood. And because I ate more goat brains, my brain is working better than Gandhi's brain. Now, which is truth, which is untruth? Did what Gandhi said is untruth or what I said is untruth? When I eat goat meat, it digests into the bone. Does goat or anything, if you like, if you don't like also, you can't try. Animal cannot try. You know, but the whole nation believes. All our intellectuals believe that it is true. Goat must have cried in Gandhi's stomach. Gandhi, it is Gandhi who is telling. Now, he did another experiment I did not like. Why do you need an experiment at the age of 74? Whether you are potent or not, by making young girls who sleep naked. Yeah? See, I also did not marry. I never had this problem. Organs work in their own way. Organs work in their own way. They are meant for that. And you must find an expression without hurting anybody, without making somebody at your past. You should know that how to. Everybody knows it. Animals know. So this is not truth. Truth was made untruth and untruth was made truth. So all my books are truth of the village India, productive India, and all their books are untruths of this nation itself. So we have to read them, we have to read us, write about us, and read them for understanding how bad they were. So thank you very much, and you all for your attention of the book.